Lake Okeechobee in South Central Florida, the site of the Bassmasters Florida Invitational, the second stop on the road to the 1987 Bassmasters Classic World Championship. There's been a lot of conversation and rumors in recent months that this huge lake is dying, that it's no longer the fishery it once was. But what you'll see in the next 30 minutes will show the Big O is okay for now. Because not only will you see the huge bass this great lake has always been known for, you'll witness an all-time Bass Anglers Sportsman Society record shattered. It's an exciting tournament with a come-from-behind last-minute charge that truly proves it's never over till it's over. Stay tuned. I'm Ray Scott. The Bassmasters will be right back from Big Bass Okeechobee and the Florida Invitational.
Lake Okeechobee, 730 square miles of bass-infested water that many anglers claim is now the best bass fishery in the world. For 3 days, 294 bass and pros, local anglers and rookies on the Bassmaster Tournament Trail will cast or flip every imaginable lure in their tackle boxes into the heavy vegetation that's home to these Florida bass. Regardless of how well some of these anglers know this lake, regardless of how often they fish it, year after year or even day after day, picking a tournament winner is no more predictable than picking the last place man. And there's good reason. Because of the tremendous numbers of really big bass here, one cast on Okeechobee can make an angler a hero, or seven casts for a tournament limit the last day can possibly move him from 100th place to first. The abundance of big bass here amazes even the tournament-wise professional bassmasters. That's not to say the fishing is as easy as making a cast and reeling in a fish, because a bass is a bass, and if he wants to eat, he will. If he don't, he won't. And regardless of how aggressively the bass are feeding, getting to them can be a problem, because this lake is filled with places a bassmaster can't get to. Miles and miles of weed and reed-choked flats that will be a secluded home to some bass for a lifetime. Areas so inaccessible that bass can live and die there without ever seeing an artificial lure come by their nose. Places where the bass share the weeds and grass and bulrushes with the herons and rails and alligators and wild shiners. Day one, and Okeechobee could not be more beautiful. Clear and calm, great for tourists, but tough for bass anglers. While many of these fishermen will weigh in a seven bass limit today, the majority of the fish will be small, many just reaching the 12-inch minimum length limit. And there's a reason. Although every bass angler is always fishing for a big fish, it's a fact that deliberately trying to catch seven small bass is a better, more predictable tournament game plan. Going for just big fish is a big gamble, because these older, heavier bass are less predictable and less abundant. A favorite game plan on the Bassmaster Tournament Trail is to first get a limit of legal size keeper bass and then go for the lunkers, culling the smaller fish. It's a good bet that a limit of bass each day anchored with a big fish will put you in the money. Regardless of philosophies and game plans, the only thing that really matters is what takes place at the weigh-in. Like now, as Texas angler Dave Fenton comes to the scales this first day.
All right, watch the scale, folks. Great weight. 18 pounds, 8 ounces. Check it again. Check it again. Let's make sure. We pivoted one time. I want to make sure. 18 pounds, 8 ounces on the money. Let's give him a nice hand. We want to weigh the largest bass because he has... Look at this fish, folks. Would you look at this. Fantastic. Largest bass you've ever caught, Dave?
Yes, sir.
What do you think she weighs?
I don't know. Once they get over about 6 pounds, I can't hardly tell.
We'll find out now. These scales don't lie. Larry, in nice and easy, and watch the scales, folks. Tighten up on the scale. Let's watch her.
6 pounds.
8 pounds, 15 ounces. Let's give him a nice hand. It's a beautiful fish. He says he wants to release a bass, although it's the largest he's ever caught.
Word travels fast when a big bass is brought in, even bringing BASS founder Ray Scott off the weigh-in platform.
That's a haul, man.
No.
You're going to go around and tell everybody.
Give me a guess.
How big a shiner did you get that on?
No, I didn't say the shiner.
I'll tell you what I'll do.
Here we go.
How much, right?
How much?
Yeah.
Hey, Larry.
Hold your bag.
That one's pegged out, isn't it?
I need that other one with me. I had another
hold
one.
Hold your bag, man.
How big is it?
They're all measured. They're all live.
3-0.
3-0.
BASS tournament director Harold Sharp, filling in for Ray Scott, handles the weighing in of the big fish.
You know, I have three bass, all alive, but one of them looks like a whale. To Larry Wright, look at this, three bass and the weight.
14.7.
14.7, and we're going to weigh this giant hog, reach in there and pick him out.
Go 11. I need him to go 11.
What are you
going
to bet?
I'm hoping 11 pounds.
I'm not going to bet with you. I'm not as good as Ray Scott on this, but for your sake, I hope he does go 11. All right, put him in the sack, and we'll tell you in a hurry what he weighs. Put the lid on him and stand back, and everybody look at this. Holy cow. Almost.
10 pounds, 14
inches. 10, 14. That's a big fish for today, right?
Even though Okeechobee is known as a big bass lake, the truth of the matter is that most of the lunkers are caught on wild shiners. And this, as Larry Wright points out, can have adverse effects on tournament fishermen who can only use artificial lures.
I'm a shiner guide, mainly. I do a lot of shiner fishing on Lake Okeechobee, and people come down here from north and they're wanting a trophy fish. And the best way to get it is shiner fishing. And we're kind of wondering about how it hinders you when it comes up to keeping up with the artificial fish for tournaments. And it is a definite problem. I've seen it for the last 6 years since I've been down here full-time guiding, that you can sit right in there and just watch just fish tearing shiners up, and you can throw topwater plugs, spinner baits, and our worms, anything you want to, and they won't touch it. And it's a definite hindrance. I can blame a lot of it in the wintertime when I'm guiding pretty regular. I just can't keep up with those artificial fish, and it hurts you. If you're going to fish full-time tournaments, you kind of need to lay them shinies aside every now and then. But as far as catching big fish, watching that bobber is tough to beat now.
Stay tuned. The Bassmasters will be right back with more exciting tournament action from the Florida Invitational and a look at the super productive technique of shiner fishing. Don't go away.